Next.js and React server components are out, and they promise big performance benefits for our web applications. Do they deliver? Sounds like a good time for some blue-collar coder performance testing. Now, before we get into it, I do want to define some terms. The primary metric we're going to be taking a look at is time to interactive. That is the time between the initial request and when the page is live and ready to interact with on the client. To get those numbers, we are going to use a simulated slow 3G connection and a commodity device. That's to give us big numbers so we can take a look at the differences between those frameworks easily. You're not going to see numbers this bad on your local host on your own machine. We're going to do all the testing in production mode. And of course, all of this code is available to you for free on GitHub in a link in the description down below. To start off with, we're going to use the Next.js 13 app directory demo page. It's a page that requires no client-side interactivity at all, and it's just a single React server component, so it makes for a great test. Next.js 13 has a time to interactive on this page of 4 seconds. Let's compare that to Next.js 13 with the pages directory or Next.js 12, which is really just the same thing performance-wise, so we'll just go with Next.js 12, which has a time to interactive on this page of 8 seconds. So that's a significant win. So what accounts for that win? Can we just take a look at what comes back from the server and see? Well, maybe. Let's look at the JavaScript bundle size first. The JavaScript bundle size on 12 is 81K, and the JavaScript bundle size coming back from Next.js 13 is 74K. So not a huge difference there. Probably doesn't account for that big savings. But it is interesting to note that Next.js 13 still gives a bundle, which it doesn't need to because there's no client-side interactivity. So that's kind of a bummer. One clue to the increased performance could be the size of the page that's returned. Next.js 12 comes in at a trim 4K, where Next.js 13 comes in at 10K. Yeah, you heard that right. Next.js 13 is actually giving you a page that's twice as big, and yet it is twice as fast. So how does that happen? Well, the secret is in an old computer science trade-off. You're trading space for time. In this case, you're creating a heavier payload so that the client doesn't have to do as much work. React requires a virtual DOM, both on the server and on the client. Next.js 12 calculates that virtual DOM on both the server and on the client in a process called hydration. Next.js 13 takes a very different approach. They calculate the virtual DOM on the server, and then they package that up as JSON at the end of the HTML document, and then send that off to the client. And now the client does not have to do the work of calculating that initial virtual DOM. They're trading off a lot of space with a much bigger page to get a benefit of increased time performance. Does that trade-off work for all applications? Let's find out as we dig into two more example applications, and we bring in a different web framework to compare that as well. Let's get right into it. Let's start right off with this new web framework that we're going to bring in. We're going to use Astro 2, but to make it fair, we're going to use Astro 2 using its React integration. So it's still going to be using React code. It's just going to be on a different platform. So this would be React with Next.js 13 on top, Next.js 12 on top, and Astro on top. So how does Astro do? Astro does great. Astro has a timed interactive of 2 seconds on this page and a JavaScript bundle size of 0. And the HTML comes in at a trim 3K. So it beats Next.js just flatly across the board in this case. So what Next.js 13 is trying to do, in my opinion, is to expand the reach of Next.js. Next.js was known for highly interactive sites that can benefit from server-side rendering. But Next.js didn't have great performance for content sites. Think blogs or news sites or portfolio sites, sites that can mainly be rendered on the server and have very limited client-side functionality. The problem was that all of the content for the blog, for example, was also duplicated in the JSON payload of the page. So the page was bloated for no reason at all. So does Next.js 13 improve? Well, to look at that, I've gone and taken an article from CNN, and I've turned it into JSON. That creates a simulated CMS payload. And now we're going to test it by having all of our React code in our platforms, grab that CMS code and render it, and we can see how fast that happens. We'll start off with Astro this time to give us a nice baseline for comparison. Astro has a 2-second time to interactive on this, and again, a 0 JS bundle size because there is no JavaScript that's required on the client, so there's no JavaScript that goes to the client. And the HTML comes in at a tight 5K with no duplication of content. Next.js 12 comes in at 6 seconds to time to interactive with a 77K bundle with a page size of 12K, where 5K of that is the serialized JSON with the CMS. So you do get that duplication. And the reason for that is that anything that you output as props in Git server-side props is serialized as JSON at the end of your file, and that's required for hydration of the virtual DOM on the client. Next.js 13 splits the difference at 4 seconds time to interactive with a 68K bundle size. The page size is up to 15K now, but that's because that CMS content is now duplicated in the JSON, but in a different way. It's duplicated because all of those DOM elements on the page are serialized both as HTML, which you need, and also that JSON, again, using that space for time trade-off. So far, Next.js 13 is looking good if you want to stay in Next.js land, but of course, Astro is doing well across the board and beating them both. But let's try something that will stress test all of these frameworks by doing something that is a combination of server-side rendering and client-side interactivity, by bringing in the Pokemon. Now we have a list of Pokemon. It is generated as a table off the server, but if you click on the name of a Pokemon, you helpfully get a JSON alert of all the data. It's pretty primitive, but it does show a client-side interactivity that we might want to see in production. So how does Astro do with this? Well, it does 8 seconds time to interactive. This time there actually is a JavaScript bundle because you need JavaScript to run this page, and that bundle is 48K, which is pretty trim in comparison to the Next.js bundles. And the overall page size is a whopping 600K, of which 180K is some form of serialized JSON to drive the client-side experience. Next.js 12 comes in at the same time to interactive with 8 seconds. Got a bigger bundle size at 77K, which I guess is the lower bounds for a production bundle for Next.js 13. One big benefit is that the page payload size is a lot less at 200K, where 100K of that is the table of Pokemon, which again was gotten by Git server-side props and sent on, and that we expect because we need that for the client-side interactivity. And this is where Next.js 13 starts to falter, because that space versus time trade-off starts to work against it. It comes in at a 10-second timed interactive, has a 70K bundle size, has a 600K download, just like Astro, but 500K of that is that serialized HTML DOM, which is just ginormous when you look at it. It's monster. It's 80% of the page. It's crazy. So for conclusions, I'm not saying that Next.js 12 or Next.js 13 or Astro are inherently bad platforms, or that this new trade-off coming in with Next.js 13 is inherently a bad thing. It depends. It depends on your application. It depends on what you're going to do with these. What I recommend is that you try each one of these frameworks out with a simple prototype application that simulates the type of interactions that you are going to have in your application so that you can understand if these trade-offs work in your favor or not, depending on the different application frameworks that you're going to use. One thing I do recommend for sure is because we have different frameworks that you try and insulate yourself from that framework choice as much as you can by trying to reduce the number of React components that have a direct connection to the framework itself. All right, well, I hope all this data helps you and your decision-making process and helps you understand Next.js 13 with that app directory and its new trade-off mechanism. But I'm sure you have a lot of insights and thoughts and comments. Be sure to put those right down below in the comments section. And if you like the video, hit that like button. And if you really like the video, hit the subscribe button and click on that bell and you'll be notified the next time a new blue-collar coder comes out.